like the mountain.
Got a secret, I promise I'd keep it. But my biggest weakness is these lips and this head. With the caption that read, best left for dead. And my thoughts are getting heavy, the sea's turning red. Putting pressure on the levees, I could understand if you let me. Never leave my hand up, set me free. And I fly when I imagine myself, because an unconditioned mind lacks the absence of hell. I say I'm doing fine, not convincing myself, but I blame it on my pride, why I don't get help. I'm here, I'm now, I hear out there is something wild. I stay in here because I'm nothing but a coward, sinking in the quicksand, admiring the trees. Something taps me on.
Voicebox battles, Tucson, Arizona. This is Game Changers. Divine Tattoo, make some fucking noise. I'm your host, Grimy L. Shout out to our sponsors, El Gallo Energy Drink, Earth Tone Drums, Grimy Republic, and Divine Tattoo. Also, special shout out to Paramount Recordings.
One right?
Rapper to my right, please introduce yourself.
It's your boy, Bad Mr. Frosty, repping the ACO. You know what I'm talking about. CZ up in this motherfucker, we coming in doing it big. Hey, if you love to do what you love to do, do it, you know what I'm saying? Step in the ring,
right.
Let's get it.
Let's go.
Rapper to my left.
Hey, it's your boy Hobbs, doing one opponent, a genius, dropping knowledge. Shout out to all these Colorado cats who came down here to do with us. We appreciate y'all. And a special shout out to my boy Derek for hooking me up with all my ink and shit like that.
So yeah.
Where'd
it
go?
Redo.
It's Tails.
I'll take the shit first.
Oh, 90 seconds. Let's go.
Preach.
Alright. Now at first, this Hamburglarer didn't want to battle me. Not just because he didn't have my money. Because he demands pedicures and manicures for his toes and his fingers for this man. That's his cure. But his hoe be exposing his weakness, saying Dan's premature. So when you talk about busting, she knows when it comes to flowing with me, she must have swam sea for sure. But let me break that shit down. Cause when I gave this bitch that juggernaut dick, making a coochie storm, she get my back looking like it was getting scratched by Wolverine's claws. She said that even if he had to shave a wet feline, he couldn't make a kitty cat or pussy cream at all. But when I looked up D on YouTube to do my homework, I found out he's so much of a rookie, he's a loss. Ain't got any battle footage seen at all, cause he can't get hired to battle. He gets fired to matches and has to clean house whoever's left the book, you see. That's how I know he couldn't be the boss. But I Booker T unhook, push and swing his jaw. If I hit him with the heavy landing, I keep the spinach, eggs, grits and veggies slamming. So one open palm smack or backside to the face will have it looking like he got smacked by a pimp who's heavy handed. But fuck getting sympathetic, faggot, when I hit his head and crash it with my Cavalier, split his egg in half and get his Chevy branded. Matter of fact, I'll behead this bastard like it's medieval times, right? Right in front of the auto parts store. New modern day sophisticated guillotine technology will get him decapitated by the Lambo butterfly car door. But he likes to sit inside of his cardboard box making backyard porn with his action figure collections of Star Wars, making Darth or Luke and R2-D2 have mixed threesomes, thinking that it's hardcore. I'll pop his top ramen off, leave his noodles out so he can fully get boiled, then deep fried in a pot to start in a pool full of oil, then to stop his heart, chop his arms, wrap this fool up in foil, sell him and bury and burn the rest of his body parts, six rulers in soil.
Ooh. Time.
Yeah. I have four battles, by the way.
Thank you for coming up, y'all. Yo. Round one, it's on Hobbs. Hold it down.
I asked for real competition. Oh, my bad, Mr. Frosty. I just thought I deserved someone better than bad Mr. Frosty. I mean, that loss to Ill Limits proves that you have ill limits. Plus, I know everyone would rather see Ill Limit. No, wait. I said I know everyone would rather see Ill. I'm it. Now when you battle with Saw Theory, you wore baby blue and pink, with a pink panther engraved on his teeth. Two color schemes that should never go together except in the case of a hermaphrodite's baby shower. Plus your mouth looks like a pussy! when you don't take care of it. And the only pussy bigger than the pink one that was on your shirt was the one in pink that was wearing it. Oh. See, I'm a perfect 10. You just a joker, Jack. How does queen think he a king when little ace laid him flat? You just a piece of shit that royal flush. He like you to think he like Texas. Hold him up, but I call you bluff. You ain't making stats and toting gats, and if you try to make a stand, you get hit like blackjack. Ooh. See, I won't play your little games. I'll just break your brittle frame like snapping a pencil. Someone tell me why I'm battling a walking, talking, human-shaped, life-size chocolate pretzel. Cause see, this clay fighter name biter's a gay writer, so I'm working with the game from which his name is inspired. See, I'll flatten this slob like the blob, and there's nothing you can do, and then stomp on him with some expensive shoes until he's blue suede goo. See, ooh, Tiny must be bonkers to step in a ring with me, and it's funny you chose bad Mr. Frosty when you built more like taffy. See, you must be fat, man. Man, I'm robbing this geek, cause it don't take a blockbuster to Victor Freeze.
Ooh. Wow. Oh.
Time. You know. Yeah. Round two. Alright, Mr. Frosty, hold it down. Let him spit.
Let's go. Alright, now this ain't no motherfucking murder moot. When I'm murder goobs, I'm the first to shoot. Why you nervous, dude, huh? What, cause I heard that you a nerdy, rude, suburban, prude, disturbing crew, perfect person who in public be surfing nude. Yeah. Up at the church with few Dutchess and German Jews and new button-up shirts and new muddied-up dirty shoes, something none of the virgins choose. Cause at his old elementary middle school, he still likes to go up there for maybe a couple to flirt with two ugly, fat, busted-ass cafeteria women, right, who fuck him and serve him food. Yeah, yeah, you know the shit you loving, that Gerber fruit. Since, you know, since you was a little baby as a little fella. Them lunch ladies was your meal sellers. And he stays eating that shit they feed him from the barbecue pit. That's why he still got stained teeth in his grill yellow. Nah, for real, hella back when he lost it, trying to get his groove back, cause he was dancing and jumping off beat but was still stellar. I was a younger MC hungry and he was a spelling bee champ king. Yeah, he was an ill speller. He won cause he spelled Cinderella. But look, I don't know how his mom and dad managed to raise this ungrateful bastard, behaving in crazy patterns, sitting there eating his snacks and chips, talking back and shit, playing his Sega Saturn. But look, I ain't playing, he'd hate if that was my grandma, cause he wouldn't have made it, she'd chase him after, fuck a spanking, she'd hang his ass, or he'd get shanked in the face with daggers. But speaking of face, his white bitch, she sucked my dick so much she's genius. She lick it up and clean it, swallow, choke, spits, then she hiccup off my penis. But Frost will spin him double helix if I just hit him with a punch, lift him up. I don't give a fuck if he was the biggest son. He still wouldn't be the hottest nigga up in Phoenix. He drives a pickup truck, I seen it. While he rides around town, driving his routes, he cries and he pouts. Like, nigga, what you upset and griping about? Cause I ain't talking about how you like to nude surf, dog, but I'm wiping you out. Whether my lines knock down your pins or drive with a fast or a curve, ball, bitch, I'm striking you out. Yeah. Time!
It's on Hobbs. Let's go.
Aurora, Colorado, the place that he calls home. So I think it's only appropriate I take shots at him like I'm James Egan Holmes. For those who don't know, he's responsible for those Batman shootings. And just like that Joker, you must be loony. I got no respect for you, and your comedy style is whack as fuck. I wish you had been in that fucking theater when that bitch shut it up. Cause your comedy camaraderie, I just can't get past it. And your punches are more stretched out than Mr. Fantastic's. Your stupid battle antics and pitiful lyrical composition got me losing my patience, like bad medical physicians. Cause you ain't nothing more than a gimmick, a joke for comedy use. You must have cataracts of the pineal gland, the way you're so blind to the truth. And if you got Lord of the Rings comparisons, yo, if you got Lord of the Rings comparisons, that's cool. Cause if that's true, then I slaughter hordes of orcs and conquer wars. Why the fuck would I be afraid of you?
Yeah.
Cause I'm a hobbit like Bilbo Baggins, but Bilbo Baggins, and in this ring, body's the only thing that Bilbo's bagging. Yo, see, I'm moving on to bigger things. This is just a casting call, so I guess I'm more like Sauron. Cause first I'll take this one ring, and then I'll rule them all. See, I don't need no bodyguards to tear apart this frail mind. Call me alcoholism, the way I'm killing them with bars. See, I'm a catalyst in this battle shit. You're not prepared to handle this. I guess it's only right that I'm high off of Northern Lights, cause I'm shining on Jairus like the Aurora Borealis.
Yeah.
See, he wishes he could be as dope as me, but that's just a fable. My bars are cracking, just like Kane, you'll never be able.
Damn. Time. Let's go. Round three. Man, Mr. Frosty. Hold it down.
Alright, look. It's clear he's sad as fuck. But I clearly had enough. Cause all I hear is that he sucks when he's near black cats and stuff. He be all talking to him saying how he's so good, but that his career is bad with luck. Not only feline, Piers was laughing, but he even cheered his bathroom up. When the lights flickered from his chandelier, his toilet flushed, his faucet ran, even his mirror was cracking up. But listen, dog, you ain't even close to me. Your flow is weak. Nutcracker poetry? You don't even do dope and tweak. You're into that Ozzy Osbourne shit, right? Sniffing ants up in your nose, you geek. Got your face bloated green like Yoda's beak. Then he grabs both his feet and just sits on the floor and rocks back and forth like this before this motherfucker goes to sleep. Then he gets cold and heat. I notice drinking lonely freaks like down to an Arizona tea. But look, you trying to take shots in the clear mist? At J-Hop is a near miss. I'm at the way top of the tier list. You at the straight bottom, you sheer shit. It's plain Hobbs is a queer bitch. How the fuck you not on some weird shit? Sucking off on the weird dicks? Dog, a bestiality necrophiliac? You really stuck your cock in the deer, bitch? That shit's shocking to hear in Frosty's ears. But since he looks like he could be a square package, he should get a spare mattress. Cause me versus him wouldn't be fair practice. With my raise the roof and the air backflips. Don't be shook, nigga, there's cameras. I ain't put you on scare tactics. This ain't no Punked, no Ashton Kutcher, you mayor actress. Face bushy and hair rabbit. Barefoot like a bear faggot. I hole punch a big ass circle through his bifocals and had his eyes bulging. Why you think E.T. is how this nigga look when he wears glasses? But as I was looking to stare past you, I couldn't help but to notice how you're so fucking ugly. You look like a fucking guppy from Kentucky that was transformed with mechanical parts from an alien abducted puppy. I said, how the fuck are you so fucking ugly? You look like a fucking guppy from Kentucky that was transformed with mechanical parts from an alien abducted puppy. But I'll fuck you up with an uppercut, D, for thinking that without having a fistful of lollipops that you could sucker punch me, right? Because even if all your bars landed hits, you still couldn't fucking touch me. So go back to poking holes through the top and bottoms of your rubber duckies.
Hey, yo.
I feel like an underground king, cause I'm so pimp C, I bet I could get this dick between your bitches buns, B. Cause I heard your bitch about as slut as it gets, taking dicks from the north, south, east, and the west. I heard several men have bust nuts on her breast, call her Monopoly, the way she got that community chest. Yo, cause you about to take the L like a hockey stick. One slap shot at J-Hop will snap off his arm like a tree branch. His crew's the contenders, but this con's tender. When my fist hits his lips, watch this snowman from Colorado avalanche. Cause so you stupid dumb fuck, you don't want it with us. I cop some brass nuts and knock this fucker unconscious when I put that steel to his grill like an orthodontist. See, me and my crew, we like Spartans, warriors at their finest. And if you bias and try to deny this, I'll roll on you with 300 like Leonidas. Yep. Now see, gum bars ain't something that I usually do. But since I heard you drop a few, I'm gonna prove that I can do it better than you. See, any gangster gimmick that you portray is an act. That's why I ain't talking mushrooms when I say I'll have him swallowing caps. See, you ask, can I bust? I reply, my speech is quite gifted. And that can I bust will leave you leaking like liquids. Cause me and my crew will rise to any occasion. Try and attack, you'll hear more claps than a standing ovation. Cause honestly, I'd really like to see how long a Frosty can survive the desert's heat. Ooh. Yo, so you better decide what your life is worth, cause I can return reinforced structures to rubble when I let fly those angry birds. So show me some respect, or I'll design a deck, cause I could build you up or tear you down when I arc attack.
Ooh. Give it up, y'all.
Joe Cutter, Cutter S. Thompson, Fresh Coast. We here in Arizona on the Humble, Hobbit, Frosty. Man, this is hard to judge, man. Jesus Christ. It was pretty much flawless from both of them. And, there was no fuck ups, no skip ups, nothing. All that shit was solid. Both of their deliveries on purpose were pretty much perfect, man. What's the Hobbit dude's name? What's his name, bro? That's his name, Hobbit. I thought it was Hobbit something else. I've seen recently, you know, getting used to all this whole Voicebox league. I've noticed that dude has progressed really well, and you know, he has some really dope lines. But I think the Frosty man, he edged that shit with all the Lord of the Rings references. So my love goes to that dude.
Yo, that sucks.
Man, got ratchet, 60-second assassin. Yeah. I'm still thinking, like, who I think won. That was a good battle right there. Hobbs and Frosty. think it all boiled down to the end. I stayed close and took a lot of load. I barely made my mind up. That was a good battle right there, but I'm gonna say Frosty.
Sean Harris, no affiliations, I'm just some guy. It was, I agree with the other two judges. It was a really great battle. Like, it was really too close to even call it. To me, it was a draw. They both had great, like, punchlines to each other. So I'm honestly just gonna call it a draw.
Yo, what's up, Tavius? I get the first round to Hobbs. Second round was really close. I would edge it out to Hobbs just based on delivery and stage presence. I get the third round to Badness and Frosty. It was like super close that third round. It was really good, but Hobbs had my attention more throughout the battle, so my vote goes for us.
J Money, aka the Black State Bully. First round, I had to give it to Bad Mr. Frosty. I think bars over his energy. Hobbs had energy, you know what I'm saying? He came with it. He had a lot of charisma, but I feel like Bad Mr. Frosty's bars were better in the first round. Second round, I give it to Hobbs. I felt like he came out delivered, spit some stuff that hit him personally. He had the Aurora flip, which was a tragedy that happened back in hometown. So, you know what I'm saying? Something that he can relate to as Bad Mr. Frosty. Third round, I give it to Bad Mr. Frosty. I thought that he had that bitch possible in the third round. So, 2-1 Bad Mr. Frosty.